Service. We're thankful that you found us this morning or this afternoon or whenever you happen to be watching. And we pray that this worship service is a blessing for you and for your family. If you're new with us for the first time, just a couple of housekeeping items. In the description below the video, you'll find resources and tools to help you during the worship service. There is a link to a worship folder that you can click on if you'd like to download it or have a printed copy in front of you. Otherwise, all the words, all the songs and responses will be on the screen for you. We'd love for you to participate along with us. There's also a digital connection card that you can fill out to let us know where you're watching from. And if you're local in the Arvada area and you're looking for a church, we'd love to hear from you. And there's also a link there to our online giving site as well if you'd like to participate in that. This Sunday in the Lutheran Church is a Sunday called the Good Shepherd Sunday. It's always the fourth Sunday after Easter, and what we'll focus on today in the scripture lessons and in the songs is that wonderful truth that Jesus is our Good Shepherd. But more specifically today, we're going to focus on how Jesus is the gate to the sheep pen. What kind of comfort is it that Jesus is a gate or a door? We'll learn about that today from John chapter 10. All that being said, let's begin our worship service. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want.
He makes me lie down in green pastures.
He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me
in paths of righteousness for his name's sake.
Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me.
Your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies.
You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life.
And I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Dear fellow members of Christ's flock, while the Lord is our shepherd and has been good to us, we have also strayed from the flock, fallen into temptation by our own fault, and been in danger. Let us confess to our good shepherd all we've done wrong and ask for his comfort, blessing, and forgiveness.
Jesus Christ, my good shepherd, I confess I have gone astray from you and turned to my own way. I haven't always listened to your voice and followed your lead. I followed my own path and fallen into temptation. Forgive me for not trusting you completely and following your voice without question.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Your good shepherd paid the ultimate price to redeem your life by laying down his life and taking it back up again. He has washed away all your sins, drenches your head with the oil of his grace, and set you on the path that leads to eternal life in heaven. Be at peace. Jesus, your good shepherd, forgives you all of your sins. Follow him all the days of your life.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Let's sing the song of praise, I Am Jesus' Little Lamb.
Every day you'll see me.
down your life for the sheep. Lead us now to the still waters of your life-giving word, that we may dwell in your Father's house forever. Open our ears to the sound of your voice in the word, to follow your promises and leading for our comfort and strength.
Amen.
At this time, we're going to have a message that's just for the children. So kids, pay attention. Sit up. If you're leaning against the couch, you're laying on the floor right now, make sure you stand up and pay attention. This message is for you. I hope you guys are doing okay. I miss seeing all of you. Those of you that come to our congregation here, I miss having you here for our children's lesson. But I hope that you're staying safe, you're healthy, and that you're also, more importantly, listening to your mom and dad and not giving them a hard time. I brought something with me today that I want to show you. This is a blanket. It's a blanket that our daughter Ellie has had since she was a little girl, a little baby. She's almost 3 now, so this blanket is almost 3 years old. And this blanket is called Owl Blankie. I think you can figure out why. There's owls all over it. There are a few things that Ellie has to have in her bed at night when she goes to sleep. And one of those things is Owl Blankie. If Owl Blankie's not in the bed with her, she makes me or my wife go and find it until she has it. And at times she'll want to be wrapped up in Owl Blankie. She covers up under it, she snuggles under it. And sometimes she'll just ball it up and she'll sleep next to it. She'll put her head on it. Ellie loves Owl Blankie. Because when Owl Blankie is nearby, she knows everything is okay. She's safe. She doesn't have to be scared of anything. Do you have a blanket or a stuffed animal like that? Something that you carry with you all the time, or you take it to bed with you? I used to have something like that too. A lot of us have had that as when we were kids. And the reason we do that is because we want to feel safe. And when that stuffed animal or that little blanket is with us and it's close to us, everything is okay. We're safe. We feel very secure. And when that thing is gone, when it's lost, we're scared, right? We worry. Where is it? I want it back. And when we find it and it's near, oh man, what tremendous comfort. That's what Jesus is for you. In the book of Psalms, Psalm 23, God said this. King David said this about God. He said, "The Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing." Jesus is like that stuffed animal or that blankie that's with you. But you know what? He's never lost. He's always with you. And because he's with you, you lack nothing. Everything you need, you have through Jesus. You never have to be scared. You never have to be afraid because Jesus is nearby. He's close to you, and he's always with you. All right, let's fold our hands, and we'll go to God in prayer. Repeat after me the lines that I say. Dear Good Shepherd, thank you for staying close and taking care of all my needs. Amen. Thanks for paying attention. We'll continue with two scripture lessons. The first scripture lesson comes from the book of 1 Samuel, chapter 17. King David is the one speaking here, but this time he's just a boy. And what David shows us is the amount of love that a shepherd has for sheep. David was in charge of his father Jesse's sheep. And so maybe it would make a little sense that if there was danger, David would run away from the sheep. But David took great pride and had a lot of love for the sheep, even though they belonged to his father. Even willing to lay down his life if necessary, he talks about that here, how he was willing to fight off enemies to keep the sheep safe. In David, we see a picture of our Savior Jesus and how he is willing to fight, even lay down his own life to protect us, his sheep. 1 Samuel chapter 17. But David said to Saul, "Your servant has been keeping his father's sheep. When a lion or a bear came and carried off a sheep from the flock, I went after it, struck it, and rescued the sheep from its mouth. When it turned on me, I seized it by its hair, struck it, and killed it. Your servant has killed both the lion and the bear. This uncircumcised Philistine will be like one of them, because he has defied the armies of the living God. The Lord who rescued me from the paw of the lion and the paw of the bear will rescue me from the hand of this Philistine." This is God's word. We'll continue with the next song of praise. Christ is risen. Alleluia. Verses 7 through 10 in our sermon this morning. Jesus said, "Very truly I tell you, Pharisees, anyone who does not enter the sheep pen by the gate, but climbs in by some other way is a thief and a robber. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep listen to his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes on ahead of them, and his sheep follow him, because they know his voice. But they will never follow a stranger. In fact, they will run away from him, because they do not recognize a stranger's voice." Jesus used this figure of speech, but the Pharisees did not understand what he was telling them. Therefore, Jesus said again, "Very truly I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who have come before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep have not listened to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved. They will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal, kill, and destroy. I have come that they may have life and have it to the full." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, O Christ.
Dear friends in Christ, what is your favorite illustration that Jesus of the Bible uses to describe who he is and what he does? Maybe it's the illustration of the king. You know, the conquering hero, the warrior who is charging out into battle, leading the troops and fighting for them, even willing to die for them. Maybe it's the illustration of the servant. You know, Jesus taking care of the poor, the disadvantaged, or on the night he was betrayed, on his knees, washing his disciples' feet. Maybe it's the Good Shepherd, that beautiful picture of Jesus leading the sheep to green pastures and quiet waters, the focus of the service this morning. But of all the illustrations that the Bible uses for Jesus, or that Jesus uses of himself, is your favorite the gate? Maybe you didn't even know that Jesus called himself a gate until I read it just a little while ago. And yet, what a tremendous comfort it is for us that Jesus is the gate. He doesn't represent a gate. He doesn't act like a gate. He really and truly is the gate to the sheep pen. And when Jesus is the gate, and because he is the gate, you have access to all the incredible blessings that God provides as part of that flock of sheep. You also have the incredible protection that only the gate can provide. John chapter 10 is called the Good Shepherd chapter in the New Testament. And it follows on the heels of a very sad thing that happened in John chapter 9. Jesus and his disciples had gone to the temple one day, and there at the entrance, one of the entrances of the temple, was a man sitting there, a man who had been born blind. And his friends or his family would bring him there to the entrance of the temple every day to beg for money. When Jesus saw the man, he healed him. And the man immediately went around the temple telling people what had happened. They asked him, who did this? And he said, well, Jesus, the man they called Jesus, did this. Some people were skeptical that it was really him, but eventually they figured out, no, that's the guy we have seen for years, seated at the entrance of the temple, and now he can see. Pretty quickly, though, the healing caught the attention of the Pharisees, the rulers there in the temple, and they were irate, because Jesus had healed the man on the Sabbath. He had broken the Sabbath laws, according to their judgment of him. And so they called the man into a room to interrogate him. Who did this? And he eventually said it was Jesus. And through the course of their interrogation, they didn't want to believe that a man of God, somebody who claims to have the power of God, would actually go and break the temple Sabbath laws. Finally, at the end of their conversation, the man who had been healed became so adamant that it was Jesus. He even said, do you want to be his followers? You're so interested in who he is and what he does. Pharisees were so upset with him, they kicked him out. Not only just kicking him out of the temple, they actually excommunicated him from the church. When Jesus heard what had happened, he went and found the man. He asked him what had happened, and the man explained it. And then Jesus asked him, do you believe in the Son of Man? The Old Testament name for the Messiah. And the man says, tell me who he is that I may believe in him. And Jesus looked at him and said, the one speaking to you is he. Jesus then went on in chapter 10 to talk about the great travesty that had gone on and how the flock of God, the family of believers, had been hurt by all of these thieves and robbers. Jesus starts out John chapter 10 calling the Pharisees thieves and robbers because what they were doing was hurting the flock of God. They weren't leading people to God, they were leading them away from God with their man-made rules, adding things to God's word, taking things away from God's word. And in so doing, they were hurting and harming the faith of so many people. So Jesus started sharing with them the fulfillment of a prophecy. Way back in the Old Testament, hundreds of years before Jesus lived, the prophet Ezekiel talked about this very thing going on. That the religious leaders, the rulers, who were supposed to be leading the flock of God to God, were leading them away and hurting the flock of God, scattering them everywhere. Because of their poor leadership, now, the prophet Ezekiel said, these sheep had been scattered all over the world. The prophet Ezekiel said that God would send someone. He would send someone, a descendant of David, who would come and gather in all of these lost sheep and bring them back into the flock of God. God himself would come and shepherd the people of God. In John chapter 10, Jesus said that he is the fulfillment of all of that. It's through him that people are brought back in. And then when you get to verses 7 through 10, Jesus starts sharing with us this other illustration of himself. Not only is he the shepherd who leads the flock and takes care of the flock and feeds the flock, he's also the gate to the sheep pen. Let's see what Jesus said in verses 7 through 10 of John chapter 10. Therefore, Jesus said again, very truly I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who have come before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep have not listened to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved. They will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal, kill, and destroy. I have come that they may have life and have it to the full. This is God's word. This illustration of sheep and shepherds and pens and so on might be a little unfamiliar to us, but to the people who were listening to Jesus, that illustration was very common. Jesus is in Jerusalem at this time when he's speaking in John chapter 10, and the southern region of Israel is called Judea at this time. The region of Judea is not very conducive to growing crops like wheat and barley, like you would have seen in Samaria or northern parts of Israel that are much flatter and more lush. Southern region of Israel called Judea was much more conducive to raising sheep, and so that's what you would have seen a lot of. If you'd gone out to the Judean countryside and sat on a hill, you could have watched a shepherd leading a flock of sheep across a hillside to these different tufts of green grass, the green pastures. Could have seen him lay the sheep down to rest and to be at peace. And at night, the shepherd would not drive the sheep back into town. More often than not, they would leave them out in the country in pens that they had built. Oftentimes, they were made of whatever was there, rocks, rough, scraggly rocks that would have been built up into walls, put thorn bushes on top to protect the sheep. It wasn't a covered element, you know, so the elements could get in, but it offered protection. And at the very end would have been an opening that the sheep could have gone in and out of, and it was the shepherd who was responsible for that entrance. In the morning, he would call them out, and then they would walk out of that pen, and they would go to the pastures, and at night he would call them, and they would come right back in there for protection. When Jesus calls himself the gate, he's telling you that he's the one who gives you access into that flock. It's through faith in Jesus Christ that you become a part of that flock of God and know what the shepherd's voice sounds like and want to follow it. He's the one who provides the access to the pasture, to the wonderful blessings that only those in the flock of God have. You and I weren't always a part of the flock of God. Like so many other sheep, like the prophet Isaiah said, we all like sheep have gone astray. Each of us has turned to our own way. But what did Jesus do? He came for the purpose of finding the lost sheep and bringing them back into the flock of God. And that's precisely what Jesus did for you. The waters of holy baptism, he called you into saving faith and gave you access into all the blessings of God. Through Jesus Christ, through faith in him, you now have the complete forgiveness of all your sins. Your Savior Jesus, your good shepherd, is the one who laid down his life and took it back up again to rescue yours. Through Jesus Christ, you have access now to those wonderful green pastures, the life-giving Word of God. And in there, you are fed on his truth and his grace and his promises. You also have what Jesus mentioned in John chapter 10, verse 10. He said, you have life to the full. Maybe you've been to a memorial service before, and they're talking about the individual who's passed away, or people are talking about that person, and in little groups, they say, he had such a full life, which oftentimes means the person had a lot of grandkids or a big family, maybe a lot of accomplishments, achieved a lot of goals, or was a big adventurer, or just did a lot of things that we're all jealous of and wish we had and could do. But Jesus is talking about something even greater than that. A life that is full is a life that is complete, a life that is given through Jesus Christ, a life that does not just end here on earth, but a life that continues on into eternity. Through Jesus Christ, dear friends, you now have everlasting life. You have everlasting life through him because you are part of this flock of God, because Jesus has brought you in. Dear friends, Jesus is the gate that gives you access into all of these wonderful blessings, the incredible blessings that God has wanted you to have from all eternity. They're all yours through Jesus Christ. But not only does Jesus, the gate, provide access to all of the blessings of God, he also provides incredible protection. I read an article one time about a man who had gone to the Holy Land in order to learn more about the culture and the geography of Israel. Because the Bible was written in real history. I mean, it's real history that's unfolding in a real time, in a real place. And so he wanted to go and see, what is this place like? What is the culture like? And he went and found a shepherd. He followed a Bedouin around and saw how he takes his flock out and leads them. And then at night, the Bedouin took the sheep to one of these pens. And the man described it, he said it was a rock face, it was a cliff. And then jutting out from it were walls that the Bedouin had built out of rocks. And as it came together at the front, there was an opening about 4 or 5 feet across. And the man who was there on the journey, he looked at the Bedouin and he asked him, where's the gate for the sheep pen? And the Bedouin shepherd looked at him a little confused. He said, I am the gate for the sheep pen. See, what that Bedouin was telling the man is that he actually slept right there in the entrance. He didn't bother with rocks. He didn't bother with wooden doors. He didn't farm out the job of protecting the sheep to someone else. He is the gate. If any predators are going to come and attack, they have to go through the shepherd. And if any sheep are trying to get out, the shepherd's not going to let them wander away where they can be in danger. Think of the incredible value that that shepherd put on his sheep. I mean, he didn't farm out the protection to someone else, somebody who might run away. He didn't rely on some inanimate object. These sheep were a source of income. These sheep were a source of wealth for this shepherd. And so he wasn't going to just let the protection of the sheep fall to anyone but himself. That's what Jesus is saying when he says, "I am the gate for the sheep pen. Any predators come and attack. Jesus hasn't left the protection of your faith to some human being, to some inanimate object. You're too valuable for that. No, Jesus, the protection of your faith, the protection of your eternity falls to Jesus. He doesn't farm it out to anybody. But when the predators come, when Satan comes roaring, Jesus fights him off. That's why Paul can say so confidently in Romans chapter 8, "I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, nor any power, neither height nor depth, or anything in all of creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord." It's because the gate is on guard. The gate is watching. The gate is protecting. Jesus, your Savior, has won your salvation. He has given you faith, eternal life, and he is going to make sure that you keep it all the days of your life. And so, dear friends, as you walk through life, enjoying all the wonderful things that Jesus does for you, don't forget about what he does for you as your gate, providing incredible access to all the blessings of God and the incredible protection for your faith in eternal life. Amen. We're going to continue with the song, "The Lamb of God." We're going to sing two verses of that song.
Amen.
Our congregation often gathers an offering to support the ministry of our congregation. On the screen, you will see, for our members, you will see the website where you can participate in that. If you're a guest this morning, please don't feel obligated to participate. If you'd like to, you can. We're just thankful that we can share the Word of God with you this morning. If you haven't had time to, you can fill out the digital connection card and let us know how we're doing with our worship services. We're thankful that we can be a blessing to you and to your family. Let's continue with a responsive prayer of the church, followed by the Lord's Prayer. Jesus, good shepherd and gate for your sheep, continue to give us life that we may enjoy it to the full. Lord, our shepherd, in you we lack nothing. We fear no evil, for you are with us. We all, like sheep, have gone astray, but you have taken away our sin by laying down your life. Teach us to know your voice, that we may follow you closely, enter your gate, and be saved. Lord, our shepherd, in you we lack nothing. We will fear no evil, for you are with us. Open the gate of your fold to other sheep. Call them also to be fed in the green pastures of your word and refreshed with the quiet waters of your baptismal grace. Lord, our shepherd, in you we lack nothing. We will fear no evil, for you are with us. With the compassion of a shepherd, walk with those who go through the darkest valleys of life, sickness, despair, and even the shadow of death. With your word, remind them of your promise and take away their fears. Lord, our shepherd, in you we lack nothing. We will fear no evil, for you are with us. Listen, Lord, to the thoughts and cares of our hearts. Lord, our shepherd, in your kindness, give us all good things, fill us with your overflowing cup, and bring us to dwell with you in your house, where you live and reign now and forever. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now, dear friends, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look on you with favor and give you peace.
Amen.
Thank you for joining us for our online worship service. We're grateful that we could share the Word of God with you. Stay tuned on svlcandelas.org for updates as we get closer to possibly having in-person worship services again. We're going to continue our online worship service until we figure out a good plan. And even once we have in-person services going, we'll still have the service live streamed for you at your home. God's richest blessings to all of you as you walk through this life with your Good Shepherd. Have a great day. Thank you.